Morning, folks. Professor G here. How you doing? Just wanted to take a couple minutes on the first day of class to show you around the site a little bit and give you an idea of what you can expect for the next month or so. All right, so when you first log on, you're going to see something like this. You're going to click on this Brightspace image here. You'll probably need to sign in, of course. And once you do that, you will end up on this landing page. Now, depending on what you've got going this summer, you may just see one class here. You may see your classes from last spring. And you might even see your ones for next fall, too. Mine are showing up at any rate. But what you want, of course, is 24SU, summer 24, kind of backwards there. GL100, which is Intro to Earth Sciences. All right, so you'll click on that. And you'll come to our class page. I'm going to switch over to student view right now. In an attempt to see what you're seeing. Just my little disclaimer here. It has been a year now for MV that we've switched over to Brightspace, but I am still pretty new to this, okay? And, of course, in that year, they've implemented some changes to the software we're trying desperately to learn, and so on and so forth, but, you know, fingers crossed, this'll go smoothly. One of the problems that is plaguing us teachers is that when we import some stuff from our previous classes, you know, instead of rebuilding the wheel, we import a last class and take bits and pieces that we want, so on and so forth. But the problem is that when we think we're deleting stuff, a lot of times it still shows up on your end in gradebook or in tasks to complete. So I picked up a few tricks, hopefully, at the end of the semester here. End of spring, and I tried to implement those. So again, we'll see. So my point being, if you ever see anything that looks out of place or you really think is, you know, maybe not something you're supposed to be doing, email me, ask. Okay. That's the biggest thing is just ask questions. You guys could never ask too many questions. Don't apologize for it. That's, you know, what I'm here for. So speaking of weird glitches, all of these little widgets over here, we call them widgets, are supposed to have little pictures in the top. Like that one, for example. These are the ponies of Chincoteague, Virginia, one of my favorite places to go. That is supposed to be the top of, yeah, and see, now it's there. I come back later, it might be gone. Let's try and load the lab one. Yeah, that's really strange. So I don't know what's going on. I already emailed tech support and they're like, well, it is the beginning of the semester and lots of people are trying to do stuff. So I guess that's a good reason slash excuse. But nonetheless, it's a weird glitch. Yeah, see, now everything's loading. This little talk I'm giving you, not much point in telling you this, but this little talk I'm giving you will be located right here under Getting Started. There's absolutely nothing there now, but that's where this will reside. So how does this class work? All right. There's me and my office. I communicate to you guys through announcements. I've already sent you a couple. All right, yesterday, Sunday afternoon, I sent you this one here. You should get this two, if not three, ways. First and foremost, obviously, it is on our class page here. Secondly, it is automatically sent, usually within a minute or two, to your email, your MV email. So if you go to another school during the school year, unfortunately, You do have to check your MV mail to see stuff from our school. All right. The other way, and I recommend this in a limited capacity, is the Brightspace app. I believe it's called Pulse. All right, so orange icon, it will. Actually, the emails take a few minutes, but almost instantaneously, the app on your phone will put a little pop-up notice for you that I just posted something. All right. And at the beginning of the semester, it can be a little annoying because I'm posting all kind of crap for you guys. All right, but come, a week or two in, things are slowing down with me working on the site. It's nice to know when I've posted new content or I've posted an announcement for you. Okay? So announcements are really, really, really important. That is the equivalent, especially in an online class, okay, when we never, really see each other. It's the equivalent of me coming in and saying, "All right, hey guys, good morning. Today, this is what's going on, or this week, this is what's going on, or, and more importantly, hey, I know we said we were going to do this, but dot dot dot. Okay, this is what's going on now. Things may change." And I even have that little, statement at the bottom of our schedule. Things might change, so. But summer usually is pretty prescribed. It works out nice. We tend to get a lot done in summer semester. So, I don't anticipate that too much, but you never know. You never know. So keep an eye out for announcements. All right. So what are we doing here? First things first, actually, we want to tackle this whole textbook thing. Talk about new on top of new on top of new. Not only, have we switched over to Brightspace, but we've switched over at MV to something called, I think it's called First Day Access, okay? And basically what happens is the cost of your textbook is wrapped into your class payment, okay? If it's a 3-hour class, they charge you, X amount for your textbook. Sometimes that's a good deal for you. Sometimes, in all honesty, not so much. But for the most part, it's a deal for you guys. What that means is please don't go buy another copy of the book. Please don't go to the publisher's website and purchase an access code. All of that is already done. So you should. This is just a dead image. I just wanted you guys to see what your book actually looked like. But down here, all right, is this. Now, again, you're going to have to log on. You're going to have to log in. I've set up a class site on here, and each individual one of you will need to come in here. I recommend, if you don't already have a Norton account, use the same dang login credentials you use for Brightspace. Okay? It's just easier that way. And here are all of our chapters. All right. Now, while we're talking about this, I am lecture based. I'm not chapter based. And what the heck does that mean? What it means, sorry, I hope my neighbor's cutting his grass. It's one inconvenience to the outside office thing. Hopefully, it's not too loud. What it means is I'm not just going to say, okay, you guys, read chapter 5 and do this, do this, do this, do this, and do this. All right. I'm going to lecture to you about sediments. That's what surface veneer is all about, right? And so I've got a couple different lectures. We've got a sedimentary rocks lecture, perhaps. This is earth science, not geology. I'm talking to you like you're my geology students, I guess. But just as an example, so I'm going to talk to you about sedimentary rocks. I'm going to talk to you about weathering and erosion. All right. And all of that stuff is covered in this chapter. But when it comes time for the testing, my tests come from my lecture, not from chapter 5, per se. All right. So it's just one of those things where when you get to the point of you're wondering what to do, how to prep for the tests, okay? Yes, you should always read the chapter that we're talking about. But if it's the night before the test and you haven't done anything yet, you're going to want to focus on my lectures, which are recorded. You'll see that in a moment. And the PowerPoint handout that goes along with the lecture, okay? Because I've taken each of these chapters and distilled out what I want you to be concerned with. And that's what I test you on, the stuff we actually talk about, not just some random question on page 73 or whatever, okay? If I don't talk about it in lecture, I don't hold you responsible for it on the test. So that's what I mean by lecture-based, okay? So anyhow, you'll see some of these chapters referenced. Hopefully, the reference numbers in the oh, and I always recommend. It's funny listening to the teachers. We had a little crash course, second crash course, third crash course in Brightspace at the end of the school year, and some folks swear by, oh my God, I tell my students to go to content, and the rest of us are like, oh, why would you tell them to go to content? You always go to course home. There's so many ways, for better or for worse, that you could poke around in Brightspace. I recommend just hitting course home and going back to these widgets, okay? Yes, everything is also here under content. I don't know. I guess I just like the visual things more than the menu. I don't know. At any rate, you do what's comfortable for you. And if you can't find something, by all means, ask. All right, so what else do we have on this page here? We've got calendar. I am not one of those teachers that is a super stickler for due dates, okay? I realize you're taking an asynchronous online class. You may have work, you may have kids, you may have other classes, you may have a job, you may have all five of those things, all right? And you're gonna get to my stuff when you get to it. And soon enough, you'll realize, if you haven't already, that if you don't do all the stuff, you're not going to do so great in the class, more than likely. So this is, a big difference between high school and college, for example. All right. I put due dates in here because that's what's suggested to keep you on track. Okay. But you don't have to email me if you're going to be 5 minutes late turning something in. Or even a day late turning something in. Okay? We don't mess around with late points or anything like that. It's due. You know it's due. Turn it in. So you're going to see these due date things. Please don't freak out. I guess one example is this map lab. This is something we do all semester. I'll talk about it a little later. Obviously, the final due date is obviously the end of the class, okay? I can't accept assignments after that class, but yeah, on an everyday basis, you don't need to email me and ask permission. I appreciate it, but you don't need to email me and ask permission, if you're going to be a half hour late or whatever, turning something in. Just get it done. This work to do is kind of redundant. And I'm trying a new trick. One of the really big annoyances, not just for you guys, but for the teachers, is that it tends to say that stuff is overdue or late. I forget what word it is uses, even if you guys turn the damn thing in. Okay? It's just a general announcement to everybody in the course. It's not personalized. All right? It's not personalized. It's not saying, hey, you. This is late. It would be kind of cool if it did that, but it's almost more like a reminder. You should have turned this in by now. And it feeds off of the due dates, really. Okay, but so somebody shared a trick at this little seminar we went to, that you guys can manually check stuff off as you complete it. And then it's not supposed to show up in this to-do list anymore. We're going to see if it works. We're sort of piloting it here. So, if those of you that are that involved, that you're doing that kind of stuff, let me know if on your end it removes it, because of course it's going to show me, because I'm not checking stuff off. I'm not doing the assignments, right? it's going to show me the overdue thing. I'm going to keep seeing that. So you guys let me know. And then announcements, and that's really all that is important for my class in particular on this page. The Learning Commons, okay, that's, if you want to talk to folks there, by all means, please do so, okay? That's the learning center, the study center, okay? The library, again, their links are on here, and it's great, both great places. But, content specific to my class, this is the important stuff. Let's take a minute. I'm not going to read the whole syllabus to you, but let's take a minute and check it out. This again is just a static image of the first page. But it's, good to read it. The whole syllabus is right here. All right. A PDF document for you. We'll go over it in a moment, as I said briefly. So, bunch of just silly stuff there. Office hours, it's summer. I'm at home, you're at home. We don't really have somewhere to meet. Most things can be sorted out by email. If for whatever reason, it just isn't working out, we can certainly set up a Zoom or something like that, okay? But I've, for the most part, things are easily sorted out over email. I do recommend, again, it is asynchronous, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, that you guys do try to set out a certain period of time every day. Every other day is a bit of a stretch, but every day to work on this class, okay? And location is also really important. I know everyone is in a different situation. Again, some of you have kids, some of you don't have kids. Some of you might have roommates or housemates or whatever. So plopping down on the dining room, at the dining room table, may not be the best choice. But again, not everyone has an office or a desk even to go sit at. But you need to do your darndest to carve out a space for yourself somewhere. And it might even be sitting in the back of Panera's or whatever. Whatever you got to do, but get a routine. That's the hardest thing with the online classes is that you don't have a set time and a set place. All right? And that's just really something I encourage as best as you can and to keep yourself in sync, especially in summer semester. We're doing what usually takes 14 weeks in a little over 4 weeks. Okay? So that you could do the math there. What is that? Triple time almost? We're doing a lot of work every week. You're gonna get a little break, spring break as it were. You'll see the schedule in a moment or two. You're gonna get a little break, but it is busy, busy work. We're going 5 days a week for 2 weeks straight. Then, as I said, you get a little break. Then we're going 5 days a week for the rest of the time. Expect to spend a couple hours a day on this class. Okay? All right. Course description, it's Earth Science. So, you got your primary components here. You got oceanography, meteorology, which is weather, geology, and astronomy. We do a little bit of all of this. And we have some labs, that attempt to match up to this stuff, sometimes more closely related than others. You need your textbook, which you automatically get. Really need you to get this mineral and rocks collection, okay? You don't have a lab book to buy. You don't have a whole bunch of other supplies, but we do need you to get this. It's just under $50, I think. It's available at the bookstore. They will mail it to you, but it's not horribly fast. I purposely put the geology section a little further into the semester, but again, we only have a month for this semester, so I can't put it too far away, because they don't always remind you when you're at the bookstore to get this box of rocks, no matter how many times I ask them to remind you guys. So please get your hands on that. The other thing you need, and I'm really not sure why it's not here, is a for some of you're going to want a paper world map, like a poster-sized map that you could stick somewhere on your wall. There is a digital option on this, and again, we'll talk about that in a couple minutes. But some folks just really want to have it on paper. I basically, I'll tell you a little bit about it now, I guess. I basically have you keep track of earth science, natural disasters. I guess all natural disasters are earth science, but throughout our semester, okay? And you mark it on the map, then on a separate sheet of paper, you tell what it is, okay? When it was, where it was, so on and so forth. In the summer, with not so much time, there doesn't tend end up being a whole lot of stuff on this map. Don't freak out about that. There's no, you need five earthquakes, six volcanoes, and three hurricanes. No, I can't. It's Mother Nature. She does what she does. But certainly if something really big happens and you somehow miss it, yeah, that's not great. But it gets you paying attention and realize that, you're surrounded by earth science. It's everywhere. It's everything. It's not just the bad stuff is earth science. There's some really good stuff. The aurora the other day, that it was cloudy in Utica, of course. But the eclipse, okay, a lot of you were able to see that not too long ago. There is some really cool stuff too. This focuses on the kind of bad stuff, though. Anywho, so there should be a map listed here. If you read about the digital stuff here when we talk about it, and then you say, "Oh God, that's not for me," please get yourself a world map. We need to add that to your list of class requirements. So anyhow, you go here, you get the syllabus. Let's click on that real quick. And you don't have to download it. It will show up in here. So the objectives, I think we've kind of talked about what you're gonna learn there. Grading. All right. We have tests and labs. I still call it everything else here. But in this class, it really is tests and labs. Your tests go into three quarters of your grade, 75% of your grade, and labs come in as 25%. And a lot of folks use that as an excuse to blow off lab, okay? There's a little caveat in here somewheres that you, well, there used to be. Mathematically, okay, you can't blow off lab and still pass the class, okay? It's is 25% doesn't sound like a whole lot, but if you're borderline, let's say you've been working your butt off and you just can't quite break that CB barrier on your test grades, you keep getting like mid to high 70s. All right, well, you turn in every one of these stinking little silly labs that I ask you to do. Guess what? You'll probably end up getting that B in the end because that 25% is enough to boost you up. Or on the opposite end of that example, you've been sliding along, barely getting C's on the tests, 70, 72, whatever. And in addition to that, you didn't do most of the labs. Well, guess what? That 25% is going to drag you right down into D territory. Okay? So, please don't blow off lab. We do not have a comprehensive final exam in here. I'm really not sure why. I was just checked to make sure this wasn't the geology syllabus that I was showing you. It's not. Yeah, we don't have a comprehensive final exam. Don't worry about that. But you will have five tests, and there is one each week. That's what I meant about it. It's crazy this in the summer semester. All right. But it's also nice because content in, content out kind of thing. All right, especially without a comprehensive final. But it's fast and or furious. Grade scale is pretty standard, 90, 80, 70, 60. Blackboard. Yeah, I think I grabbed a very outdated syllabus here, to copy over and update. I didn't. We don't have Blackboard anymore, obviously. It is D2L or Brightspace. My email hasn't changed though. This personal electronic device is in the classroom. This is in quotes, obviously, there. This is talking about your workspace, like I was just telling you a couple minutes ago. Cell phone interruptions. You know, I know we're all glued to these things, me included. Okay. But if you can, at least put the sucker on mute and set it off to the side so you're not, you know, trying to text three people and scroll through this and scroll through that while you're listening to my lecture. You probably wouldn't be doing that in the classroom, so you probably shouldn't be doing it when you're taking an online class. Also, and this goes without saying, but unfortunately I have to say it, these tests are closed book. You're on the honor system here. Please don't Google your answers. We do have time limits on the test for that very reason, okay? Because if you just try to look up every answer, as you can imagine, it's going to take a heck of a lot longer than it does to if you actually had just studied, okay? So that's why there's timers on the tests, but it's an unfortunate necessity. So please don't Google stuff, okay? Speaking of which, cheating and plagiarism, please refer to the student's handbook for the policies regarding cheating and or plagiarism. Extra credit. Also, please don't email me and say, oh my god, I did so horrible in that last test, what can I do to improve my grade? Because all I'm going to tell you is study differently and or longer, okay? I don't give extra credit out to individuals. I will throw out things like article summaries here and there for the entire class to take advantage of, and that's your opportunity to do so, to earn some extra credit. I give out test points. Remember how we said your grade is based on tests and labs? So test points are worth a whole lot more than lab points. So whenever I do give you extra credit, even if it's just a point or two, that goes on to one of your tests, let's say your lowest test. They add up a lot faster. For example, I try to give 50-point questions. We've sort of gotten away from that a little bit now that we're online here. My classes are, a lot of them are online. I gave 50-point tests because it was really easy for me to do the math when I was grading them, I'll be honest with you. Because all you do is double the number correct. Let's say you got a 45 out of 50, well, that's a 90. All right, you could do the longhand math if you need to see what I'm talking about. A 40 out of 50 is an 80, so on and so forth. So it was just super easy for me. But using that as an example, all right, let's say you got a 40 out of 50 on the first test, which is great, by the way. Science tests are different than your history test or a psych test. Or science is a totally different head, okay? And for those of you not familiar with it, it might take you a little bit to get used to how that all works. So if you're used to getting A's and you get a B or even a high C on the first test, don't freak out. You'll get there. And you got plenty of opportunities to get there. Anywho, back to my point. So let's say you get that 40 out of 50 and that's an 80, okay? However, I then give out an extra credit article summary and you get it back and you got 2 points on it. You're like, oh yay, 2 points. Well, that takes your 40 and turns it into a 42. A 42 out of 50 is an 84. You just jumped 4 percentage points. And that is a big deal. So, when I put out the extra credits, take advantage of them. All right, anywho, I said I wasn't going to read this whole thing to you. Missing a test it really stinks in the summer because there just isn't time for catching up, okay? If you've got something weird going on in the middle of our semester, email me, tell me what's going on, and we'll try to sort something out for you, all right? Even if it's drop this class and take the geology that runs through July when this is done because maybe you're not doing as much stuff in July. There just isn't time for makeups. I don't do the drop lowest grade or anything like that. This is just my standard policy here, but I'm telling you the reality of summer semester with one test a week. All right, by the time you get around to making up that test you missed, it's time for the next dang test. And guess what? You probably won't do so swell on that one because you just took the other. You see where this is going. So, anywho, try to stay on track. And I know I said I don't have due dates, and that is true. The exception to that, of course, are tests. Students with disabilities, all right, access services is what we call it on campus here, OAR, Office of Accessibility Resources. They change their name very frequently. They are OAR now. They were Access Services just before that. Before that, they were offices for students with disabilities and so on and so forth. I'm old. I'm trying to keep up with the language, but I'm doing my best here. But if anyone in the class has any type of issue, be it physical, mental, health, okay, anything like that, talk to me. If it's something that needs official paperwork, long-term kind of stuff, you definitely want to check in with these guys. I'm pretty simple. I'll work with you. If it's something we decide maybe you need to have on record, or you decide you should have on record, please check in with these folks. You can email them. You can call them. I guess it automatically goes to a message. This is a sort of a patent statement they give us to paste into our syllabi. And I'm looking, I think this one is actually kind of outdated too. All right, I guess I'm going to be working on our syllabus this week and updating it a little bit. But I think there is supposed to be a space there between at and OAR. It's not a tour at MVCC. It's at OAR at MVCC. So there should at the very least be a space there. And this still talks about COVID. So, and unfortunately folks are still getting COVID. But this is a little older. Sustainability, only print out what you need to print out, folks. And Title IX, again, in the situation that we're running this summer, really shouldn't be an issue for you. But, God forbid something comes up, please, let me know what's going on. And we will go for there. We don't even have discussion boards in this class. So there's no forced interaction, if you would. So any questions about any of that, please talk to me, and we'll try and clarify whatever was unclear for you. Okay, let's talk about your day-to-day. Let's look at the schedule real quick. I got so tied up in that syllabus, I forgot about the schedule. I do not have one of these. I don't know. Let's see what happens if we click on this. You see, I do not have one of these for you to download, but I guess if you click right there, you could download this and print it out if you wanted to, which isn't a horrible idea. Put it in your workspace. And by the way, here's that little checkbox, okay, that I mentioned. This isn't an assignment. I'm not sure why I put the checkbox here, but some of the labs, for instance, will have these as well, okay? And that's your way of a checklist, literally, okay, of saying, okay, I did this already, because things are going to get fast, as I said. All right, so let's look here. This is this week, and every day is a calendar day is on here, and the day, so Monday through Friday, every week. This lecture hours, this was mainly for me to keep track of things. You need so many hours of lecture, so many hours of lab. They call them Carnegie hours. It's a academic thing, a 3-hour class, a 4-hour class, a 1-hour class. That actually means something, all right, and it's how much time you spend in the classroom. Covering material, and how much time is expected outside of the classroom is derived out of that as well, working on material. So that's in there, and I just decided to keep it. It helps me keep track, and if someone ever wants to see our schedule and see what we're doing, they'll, someone is in a administrator, something like that, they'll be able to see, how we're keeping track of stuff as well. So anywho, first lecture is actually posted today, okay? But you're gonna end up spending an hour. I didn't mean to talk that long, but it's 35 minutes already and we're not quite done. So you're gonna end up spending an hour listening to me. You might not get through all of this today. And then tomorrow we start the Investigating the Earth series. It's a handful of lectures. And then, as promised, the end of the week, we'll have test number one. All right. And then in order to have our time requirement, we also have a we'll have a movie of some sort that we're going to watch. Sometimes they'll have questions to answer, sometimes they don't. But they're always, pertinent. So please watch those assignments when I give them to you. The video, that's why I call them a video lesson. It's not just movie day. All right, it is a lesson. Here's the chapter number column. So this is the preface. And the chapter number where you'll find this stuff in. And this also goes back to what I was saying that I'm not chapter based. We don't always necessarily cover a whole chapter at a time, or like this meteorology stuff. Okay. Bits and pieces of it come from three different chapters, 17, 18, and or 19. Okay, so it's all in there. It's just not hurricanes is one chapter. Intro to meteorology is another chapter, and so on and so forth. So my lectures come from these chapters. Same thing with the astronomy stuff. All right, anywho, so that's what that's about. Here's our labs column. Again, you have lecture and lab for this class. You'll be doing the labs at home. You don't need a whole lot of stuff for them. They're mostly there's some activities that you'll be doing. But unfortunately, they're mostly the paper and pencil kind of labs. It does stink, but we try to make it a little more fun when we can. And that's where the box of rocks and minerals comes in. Constellation lab, you're actually going outside. Cloud journal, you're outside. So virtual earthquakes is online. It's an activity. So we do try to mix it up a little bit, but a lot of it is paper and pencil stuff. So this week we're doing three labs. Usually you have one lab a week. Okay, I'm just trying to emphasize how things are accelerated in the summer. Okay, we do three labs the first week. This one runs the entire semester, this natural disasters map. You really want to take some time out today, figure out if you're going to do this digitally or on a piece of paper, find a paper map, go on to Amazon, run to Walmart's, whatever. Check the teacher section at the Dollar Tree. Okay, sometimes they have world maps there. Get that running. All right, hopefully nothing horrible will happen in the world today, but you never know. And that's the other thing. I've said the word world several times already, and inevitably a handful of people end up turning in a map of the United States. This is the entire world we're keeping track of this semester, not just a USA project, okay? So make sure your map is the right kind of map. Math and science review in the ruler lab. I'll show you where those are in a little bit. That's this week. Next week we start the cloud journal. That's actually going to run for the entire semester as well. We'll talk about that when we get there. Extreme weather is watching some videos, answering some questions, stuff like that. And these are worksheets. Constellation lab, you go out at night. And take some pictures of constellations and whatnot using an app. It's kind of cool. So, anywho, so that's your schedule, okay? Lecture test number two is next Friday. Lecture test number three, remember I told you get a bit of a spring break? All right. The third week of classes, or the first week of June, the test number three is actually on Thursday. Then you have Friday and Monday off. There's your spring break. So schedule something fun and relaxing to do there. Not catching up on your work. And speaking of which, for that very same reason, I've scheduled all the lab due dates to be like 2 or 3 o'clock on Friday afternoon because I don't want that hanging over your head over the weekend. You take the test on Friday, you turn your labs in, and you're done. You can worry about other things in your life for a few days. Until we come back on Monday and we start up again. So that's why I put the due date where I put it. Okay? All right, anywho. So you got that nice little break there, 4 days break. You come back, we start the geology unit, test at the end of the week. Then you come back, and oh my gosh, we're done already. Say, wait a minute, I thought this was a 5-week class. Well, it's really based on these lecture and lab hours. And we got it done. So we get done early. All right. We'll actually be done with this class, subject to change, but I'm planning on being done with this class by June 20th, not the 24th, I think it is. It's the Monday. It's not a huge difference. We're ending on Thursday instead of Monday. But I think by the time we get there, you will appreciate that. This last unit is oceans and just general water stuff. I know I threw water cycle in way back here. We need it for talking about the weather, obviously. But so we're going to talk about some more stuff like that a little later in the semester. So that's your schedule. These are lectures, all right? These are labs. They're in two different widgets on the page we're going to go to in a minute. So the pictures are staying. That's encouraging. I just don't know why they weren't there first thing this morning. So lecture. What do we got here? There's my ponies. All right, so we have modules. So you actually have to see this week one. Eventually you will see, it won't scroll anymore because there's nothing else. You will see week two. What did I say we're going to next? Weather. So week two, meteorology. Week three, geology. Week four, astronomy. Week five. I guess we are doing 5 weeks. Week five, oceanography. Okay. So anywho, you click on the module, and hey, now it opens up. So we have the lecture cast and the PowerPoints. I do recommend, I'm all for saving a tree and whatnot, but oh, I didn't put the PowerPoints in yet. All right, I'll do that as soon as I'm done recording this. Crud. So you're gonna have PowerPoints in one folder and the lecture cast in the other. It's totally up to you. You're gonna see the PowerPoint as we play through here. It's gonna take you, they're all on YouTube for captioning purposes. The captions sometimes aren't great, okay? But they are pretty decent. Alrighty, folks. Today we are going to talk about the, well, science, the nature of science, scientific method. Funny story, folks. I just realized that I accidentally paused the recording a couple minutes ago, and I honestly don't know what I said or didn't say in these last 5 minutes, probably. Other than this is what I expect you to do this week, okay? It is a lot of assignments, especially since this one is taking so long. All right. And I can't believe I got confused when I was playing a video for you. All right. I was trying to pause the video.
Hey there, folks, and today we are going to talk.
And I accidentally paused the recording as opposed to the video. So I'm going to show you a couple things real quick. It allows you to have the option to watch this on YouTube. Okay. But it appears that you could do darn near everything, even go into full screen.
Talk about atoms and stuff.
You could turn on captions, turn off captions if you don't want them.
There we go.
You could even go full screen.
As I was just telling the folks in the room here, this is something that you quite likely had before in life. All right? But the
And
details
here's
might
the
be a little.
pause here. Not my butt. I don't even know if you guys can see the timer going down here, but there's a little timer and a play button. So I totally messed that up. So what you're hearing is me lecturing this past spring, okay, to my on-campus class. Earth science never runs on class, but on campus. But there are a handful of lectures that I either give in all of my classes, or that do cross over from geology to earth science, or environmental science to earth science. All classes that I sometimes get to teach on campus. So I use those recordings, and in a few instances, some are older than others, but in a few instances I made them, you know, outside of class, sitting here on my deck or upstairs in my office or whatever, and I record them there. But they're much more interesting to talk to an actual class, so those tend to be better conversations, which is why I use those. All right. That being said, please don't pay attention or worry about anything if I may accidentally slip up and say something about a test coming up or whatever. That's from a different semester. I try not to do that while I'm recording for this very reason, but sometimes I forget or it's just unavoidable. So if you hear anything about tests, or like I said, it's the announcements for this semester on the homepage. That's what really matters, and that schedule we showed you on the homepage. So anywho, hopefully I'm not forgetting something that I said while the recorder was off, but this is this week's lectures. I don't know if the recorder was on while I said this part or not. This is that little checklist I gave you, okay, or that I told you about, and it's a personal thing. You're done with this one, okay, check it off and see how that changes. Boom, and it's all maybe even motivational for you. I'd love to use this to give you guys points. Like, okay, this student listened to all these recordings, so they earned, you know, 25 points. But in all honesty, what's to stop you from doing boom, 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 and not actually listening to any of the videos? So I can't use that for that purpose right now. And maybe I could weaponize it somehow. But I don't know. I don't have those skills at the moment. So as I said, they really just serve for helping you keep track of things and at the very least getting rid of these annoying, nothing's overdue yet, so you won't see it. But next week you might start to see them. The annoying overdue notices down here. All right. I really don't want this to go longer than an hour, so let me get myself into gear here. Last thing we have to talk about, I think, is lab content. Again, there's only a couple labs showing up right now, but you see how there are the previous, you know, the upcoming weeks are here. So this week, natural disaster map lab, we'll click on that first. There's some instructions here. I kind of already told you what's going on. I don't know what I would want to do if I were in your shoes. It really depends how comfortable you are working with digital images, opening up Adobe Acrobat and drawing on things. I'm a Mac guy. We have something called Preview, and Preview allows you to draw on stuff really easily and just resave it. Acrobat, which is Adobe Reader, Acrobat Reader, is free, all right? And that has some editing tools on it as well. Like a lot of folks, you know, they'll say, well, I couldn't afford that. No, it's free. Yes, there are many, many, many paid versions of it, but there's free. The base system is free, and it does have a decent amount of work on it. So here's a map, and you would, however you steal images on your own computer, you know how to do that, more than likely. See, that one just did a HTTP. So it really depends, unfortunately, on the, let's see, oh, there we go. Now I grab the whole unit. So on a Mac, it's as simple as dragging it off. Let's see, is it? Yeah, here it is. That's me in Utah a few years back. And it's off the screen, but I'm going up in Preview here. I'm going up into Tools, Annotate, and you know, you do what you want to do. I've seen so many cool things with this. You guys managed to find little icons, and you put a little pointy mountain here if a volcano goes off, or there's a little storm insignia, I think is the word I'm trying to say here, that they'll put to mark a... this is... You guys can... Anything that happens, if there's a mudslide, feel free... Oops, I don't want to draw on this. I want to just move it. You know, feel free to put the mudslide on. If there's a wildfire, all right? Apparently there's wildfires going in Canada again. The smoke hasn't hit New York yet, but I think the Midwest is starting to have some issues with this. And undoubtedly, unfortunately, those will probably spread. This is a world map. Put the wildfires in that are in Canada. Don't just limit yourself to the couple things that I suggested. Their suggestions. Anywho, so they find little icons. At the very least, and I suggest that in here. Sorry, it was up already. Where do I suggest it? Boy, if I can't find the attachment, how are you guys going to... Oh, there's the instructions. Boy, there's no space at all there. I'm going to try and put a space in there. All right. So I suggest doing E1, V1, or S1, Earthquake 1, Volcano 1, Storm 1. And the next one would be Earthquake 2, so on and so forth. You could label it that way. I suggest using colors. You can do whatever you want. This is a sort of an artistic liberties, artistic freedom. I'm really open. Do what you want. And as I said, some people manage to find cool little icons that they placed on the map. That's awesome. Have some fun with this. All right. Any assignment that you can have a little bit of fun with it makes it better. Okay. So do that. And here's what I say. I don't want you out there combing the web for this. My homepage, and it's probably going to be full with political crap right now. I'm old, as I said. I've got Yahoo as my homepage. But if something shows up here, okay, if it shows up, if it pops up on your phone, if you've got the Weather Channel app, all right, they're great for popping up, not just weather events, but volcanoes, earthquakes, they mention everything. We want newsworthy events, because here's the thing. If you go to, I think it's org, but we're going to type in .com here.
USGS. The HP 1 cent stock.
Ah. Wow, that was unnecessarily loud. Okay, and it's not even USGS.org. The hell's their address? .gov. So, if you go, and actually here's a great way to find out about forest fires too. They have an earthquake page, okay? If you attempt to, by a little bit of Googling, find out that the U.S. Geological Survey keeps track of earthquakes, not just in the U.S., but in the world, you're also going to find out that we have about 3 dozen earthquakes a day. Any given place on the planet. You don't want to record those. Okay? Yes, it stinks for whoever may happen to be near them, but the majority of them are in the middle of nowhere, literally in the middle of nowhere. And again, if some small population does happen to live near them, it is quite unfortunate, but it is unmanageable for you, is my point. All right, it very quickly becomes unmanageable for you to try and, this is not showing us all the ones. This is just that one. Okay. Well, there is somewhere on this site that shows, you know, every single earthquake that happens. And there's a beautiful example. All right. It happened to be centered on California for whatever reason, probably what I clicked on. But look at that. You can't record all those. So this is why I limit you to the newsworthy. I forget how I actually say it. If you hear about it, see it on your phone, on your web page. God forbid you actually still watch the news. Okay. That's something we want to see on there. All right. Anyhow, so make sure you get the instructions as well, not just this little blurb here. There's a couple different digital maps. You're also welcome to go out and find your own. This one is kind of nice. It's a little plainer than the other one, but it does not have your states on it. It's just country-based. But you would literally need to then, you know, enlarge this a little bit, write on it with the digital thing. And then at the end of the semester, you would turn this in, plus probably, you know, whether you use Google Docs or Word, whatever, your key that matches up to this, okay? Because you're just going to put the little icons here and there. You're not going to put all that data on the map. That goes on a separate key. And now you can see why some people just want to use a paper map. They draw on it with a permanent marker and they're done. Last thing I want to touch on, go back to these instructions for a minute, is there is a part two that a lot of people forget to do. Part two has you drawing the plate boundaries on it. All right, at some point in the semester, we're going to talk about plate tectonics, and you're going to be drawing the plate boundaries. And the point here was that, as you'll hear in the plate tectonics discussion, and a couple other times in the semester, is that a lot of these events, earthquakes and volcanoes in particular, are supposed to happen around these plate boundaries. So once we draw in the plate boundaries, we get to see if it actually happened. So going back, the last thing, turning it in, if you're doing it digital, it's fairly simple. You're going to include your map file and the your answer key. If you do a paper map, I ask you to take a one big picture of the map, one picture of the whole map, and then maybe a close-up here or there of a you know, where you have some clusters of stuff, okay? You know, show me what you actually tagged on there. And then you still turn in a picture of your answer key. So you're going to be taking pictures with your phones. You guys will probably get used to that because, again, in lab itself, let's open up one of these. Most of you, I imagine, are still going to, come on, download. Most of you are still going to download the attachment. You're going to print it out on your printer, and you're going to write on it with a pencil or a pen. The question then becomes, how the heck do you turn that in? I have no idea why this isn't loading. The answer is, you take a picture of it with your cell phone, and you either attach that to an email to yourself on your laptop, or you figure out a way to get it. Some people just go right to the class site on their phones, okay? But you would upload it, submissions right here, okay? You upload it right there. If I wanted you, for some reason, to talk your answer to me, so... at any rate. So that goes there. I don't know why. Let's try one more time. Yeah, don't tell me this is the website being busy because it's a lot of campuses starting up summer classes. All right. Well, if you guys are having the same problem on these, please let me know. There's a possibility, as you know, that it's my home my home Wi-Fi that's acting up. I might say that this is server side. This is something going on with D2L. And some of you, again, if you have the tech, you know how to edit a PDF. All right. Feel free just to type into the spaces here, resave it, and submit that. Let's see here. So here's an example of the ruler lab, all right? And like I said, most of you will just print this out and write in it and then take pictures. But a handful of you know that you can, and it's kind of a pain in the butt. Here's a text box. And my kitchen table is 4'5" long. Why is it writing in white? Oh, that's highlight. See what I mean? Pain in the butt. 4'5" long, the nearest rock. And sometimes you don't even have to do text. Let's see if this is, yeah, no, this one isn't editable. Depends on the app you're using. All right, we move that up. All right, and the length of my hair is 2 inches. So on and so forth. All right, and then you go over here and you resave it. And then you submit that. Okay. Anyhow, yes, still hasn't loaded. Let me know if this is a problem for you guys, or please even, you know, give me positive feedback. Say, no, it downloaded great. Okay, and you would just send me an email. By the way, my email, don't use this thing. Don't send me an email through D2L. Send me an actual email from your actual email account. Please use your MV so it doesn't go into spam. Okay? It is ngiopppo@mvcc.edu. It's right there. Okay? And let me know if you're having issues. All right. I'm sure I've forgotten something, and I really didn't mean to take an hour of your time doing this. I apologize, but hopefully you feel that you've now had a very thorough introduction and walkthrough to our course. I'm going to spend some time here in a little bit and fix that syllabus up a little bit. But right now, you guys should have more than enough work to do, and I probably will not bother you anymore today. Unless I get some feedback from you that, you know, the links are still acting up, so on and so forth. All right, so have a great day. Have a great week. It was nice to meet you guys. That's me. Hi, Smiley. And I'm still sitting right there, except my iced tea is now slightly warm, or my iced coffee is now slightly warmer and watered down because I've been talking and not drinking. Have a good day. Bye-bye.